Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. Welcome to the video where we are sitting down and testing out the new makeup from Pure Cosmetics, and I am freaking excited. You guys know, obviously, I love to test makeup. It's what I do, but I'm extra excited about this one because at first, when I saw the concealer on the Ulta website, I thought it was just going to be like a launch limited to just this, like one item, you know, wasn't anything crazy, you know, over the moon. But then I waited a couple of days, and I noticed that they also added on these couple of goodies. We have a 4-in-1 loose setting powder. We have a face palette here, a mascara, as well as a lip treatment. And at first I wasn't sure if this was gonna be like a dedicated video or if I would rope it in with other products, but I decided in the end to give them kind of their own moment because with Pure, they really don't come out with like, you know, launch after launch after launch. I feel like they do a pretty good job at spacing them out. And I just kind of wanted to give them a moment, see if their stuff is good and really dive into it, dive into textures, consistencies. And actually while we're doing this here, let's go ahead and get started with the lip treatment. This again is the Pure Forever Soft Rejuvenating Lip Treatment with Superfood Blend. And this is basically just a moisture-rich formula, and it has the cannabis sativa or hemp seed oil in it to moisturize and soothe. It has an energy complex, which it says is a combination of green tea, ginseng, and vitamin B that will help boost the skin's natural metabolism and rejuvenate the look of the skin, which thank God, y'all, my lips, I have got the crusty, busty-ass Northern Michigan trade lips right now, and they're in a need of a little help, so I'm very excited for that. And then it also says that it has the superfood blend, which include, what is this, a mixture of sunflower seed oil, vitamin E, aloe juice powder, okay, apple extract, and lentil extract for a healthier and more radiant looking appearance. So that's maybe going to give it like that glossy texture, I don't know. And it also said on there too that, that it had a different applicator. Okay, I thought this was just going to be like one of them slanted little metal tips. I didn't think it was going to be a ball. Do you guys see this? It is a ball. Oh my God, I'm excited. Okay, so it comes out, there's like a little spark, just a little bit here comes out the tip. And then you just kind of, wait, is the ball gonna roll? Oh, it is, it rolls around like this. Oh, I actually need to dispense some. Okay, so we're gonna do some of this. The product of this actually does feel really nice. I was a little bit hesitant because with lip stuff, you know, you never know if it's just gonna be like thick and goopy and glossy, if it's just gonna be weird creamy texture. But this one is kind of like a nice mixture of the two. It has a nice amount of hydration, but it's also not overly glossy. I feel like you can like barely see it on the lips, which is interesting. But it does feel really good. Okay, so far so good. All right, so now we're just gonna go ahead. I scooched the camera in just a little bit, and I wanna start going into the concealer. So before I go there, I'm going to prime really quickly. And for that, I'm just gonna use a little bit of the NYX Marshmallow Primer. Also, while we're doing this, let's maybe do the entire spiel that I normally do at the beginning of my videos. If you're new here, hello. I do put up 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, typically right around like 7:30-ish a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. So make sure you subscribe, turn on your post notifications, and then also make sure you are following me over on Instagram because I put up a ton of content over there. Everything from plus size fashion, makeup, all that stuff. And then I'm also very, very active in the IG stories. If you're ever looking for like a quick pick me up, if you want to talk about, you know, music or wine about it, anything like that, I'm always hanging out in the feed. So make sure that you check it out. Oh, and I'm trying to hit 10,000 followers. So you'd be doing me a personal favor as well. But again, beyond that, there really is a ton of content. So make sure you check it out. I'll have everything linked down below. And from there, that's just nice and pressed in. God, that primer. Guys, I've talked about this 1,000 times, but this primer is so great. Highly recommend. By the way, too, everything that I'm using today, I will have linked down below. Whether it's from Pure or just anything else that I use, I'll make sure everything is down there for you. Now, let's go ahead and start getting into this concealer, which I don't know if I mentioned this yet, but I have the concealer in the shade LN2, and this is their Push Up 4-in-1 Sculpting Concealer. Okay, so what the hell am I missing here? It's not a little cap. Hold on. Is this a it's a button. A button. Okay, so check this out. You see this little situation here? Look at. Oh, what? Hold on. Pew. Okay. I like this. I like where we're going. Pure, I'm seeing what you're doing and I'm digging it. All right, let's go ahead here. Applicator is more of a flat little paddle brush. Nothing mad there. And I'm starting with this one in the areas that I normally would go. So a little bit on the jaw, T-zone, and then of course under the eyes. I would say it's giving me like a standard medium coverage. There's still a little bit of blue popping through, but the finish of it is more on the natural side, which I like. It's not hyper matte. It's not overly, you know, dewy or luminous. It's like sitting, you know, somewhere nice and in between. My under eyes look, you know, just healthy and awake. And then even blending it out onto my forehead, actually, this area looks really good too. Okay, all right, I'm not mad at you. So of course with concealer in me, there's always two things I have to check. Number one, I like to build coverage. As you can see, I just added a little dip here to the under eye just to see if you can completely eliminate the blue bags. Okay, so you know what? I would say that actually does build up pretty nicely. I can definitely tell there was more of a blue hue right through here. It's always hard to see on camera, but in real life, that definitely helped kind of drop that shadow down, which I like. So I do think that this is buildable to a point. I don't think it's gonna be buildable to like a hyper full, but I'm liking where it's, you know, where it's sitting right now because it did maintain that natural finish, which is important too. And then the second thing that I like to always check with my concealers is if they work as a spot concealer or not. I like to do this just because it tells me what the scope of the concealer is. Like, is it, you know, one that really only works under the eyes? Is it fluid enough to go all over? And don't get me wrong, it never bothers me if a concealer is, you know, only really good in one area or another area. I think for me, it's just more about knowing going into it, like, where is it gonna work? And, you know, I think that it did help to deaden the redness, but I'm not like overly impressed with it. I can still see a lot of the redness peeking through. But before I give up completely on this idea, I do want to go in with a brush. So I just applied a little bit more to those same spots. And I just want to pat it in this way just to see, because the texture of this has me curious. That made such a huge difference. Look at that. Like, just going over, I literally patted it in like 3 times and the coverage is infinitely better with a brush with this one. And then just to satisfy my curiosity, I'm gonna take just a touch more up under the eyes and see if that would be the difference there. Because again, for people that need that fuller coverage under the eyes, I wanna know if you'll be able to get it with this. Oh, wow, that really, man, that does make a huge difference. Now for foundation, I'm just gonna go in with some of the Clinique Even Better foundation. This is one I have tested and I've talked about before. I'll link my video up here, but this is in the shade CN08 Linen. And I'm picking this foundation because the concealer does have more of a natural finish to it, like a natural, not only finish, but the way that it covers looks very effortless. And so I figured I would pair it with a foundation that has a similar finish. And on me, this one from Clinique does that. All right, so now it's time to test out the new powder from Pure. This is their 4-in-1 loose setting powder. And it says here that it is a lightweight blurring powder and it was available on the Ulta website in 3 shades. I grabbed the shade Translucent. Oh, and I like this packaging too. Look at this. It has like a little inset right here where the little sponge that it comes with goes. And it looks like you spin this. Wait, how the hell does this thing? Oh, wait a second. Hold on, how does this work? Does this pop up? What happens here? Okay, so guys, I must be missing something here because all there is for this, like, you can't take this silver part of this lid off, but there's like this little teeny tiny oval right there. I don't know if you guys can see it, but there's like a little oval. There it is. And the whole lid, like the whole upper piece, slides like so. And when it slid shut, it's red, right? So you can't get anything out of it. But then when you slide it this way, the little powder spout, I think, is supposed to open. But then from there, it's like the teeniest little spout. And I honestly can't figure out, like, is that all the space that I have to work with? Because y'all, I got a big ass face. I'm gonna be here for an hour trying to get powder out of this. Like, I've been sitting here tapping for a year and that's all the powder I have. Hello? All right, so I just got enough out in the cap here to go ahead and do my under eyes. And that is where I'm gonna start. So I'm just pressing out this whole area right here, making sure that I don't have any creases. And then going in with my damp sponge, I'm just going to press that in. Does that smell like, ooh, it smells like vanilla. Oh my God, it smells exactly like their bronzer. Oh my God, you guys, if you've ever smelled how delicious their vanilla ass bronzer is, oh my God, this smells exactly the same. So nice. All right, so texture wise, I'm just gonna go ahead here and start pressing it into the forehead. Texture wise for me with this one, I gotta be honest, normally this thin of a powder, it's a very, very finely milled powder. Normally this doesn't work as well on like my under eyes or my forehead, areas that are more crevassy, because typically it tends to settle out. But so far, so good. Actually, it looks really nice. It does have more of a blurring effect, which I really, really like. Like, I'm not mad at that at all. Now, I will say, per usual on me, my nose is looking a little bit funky, like right on the sides of the nostrils, which is where my pores are the most egregious, so I'm not surprised about that. But what is throwing me off about this a little bit is the color, and there, I'm not having any issues with it. Like, yes, it is a little darker than I thought it would be for my under eyes. Typically, I like them to be a little bit brighter. Which, just for a frame of reference, I wanna show you guys the two powders next to each other. This is the Lift and Luminate number 7 powder that I'm used to using. And you can see this one, sorry, it's being kind of a pain in the ass. But this one over here is definitely on the darker side. It has more of like a cooler tone to it, which I'm not mad at. I actually do really like the tone of this. But again, just for what I thought I was getting under my eyes, I thought I was getting something that was brighter, whiter, more like this powder. And it turned out to be more like this, which again, not bad necessarily, but just something to keep in mind if you're looking at the different shades. Now, really quick, I'm just going in with a little bit of the Fenty Pro Matte Foundation Powder here. This is in the shade 150, and I'm just taking that all over to lightly set the face. All right, so I think what I'm gonna do, I was kind of sitting here trying to like devise a game plan, and because I do wanna test out a little bit more of this powder from them just to see how it looks like shaping out the face and stuff. But before we get into that, I wanna test out this 4-in-1 face palette. I have this in the shade Fair Light, and it says here that this palette features a stunning mix of bronzer, highlighter, blush, and translucent setting powder arranged in a sleek, travel-friendly palette designed to help you sculpt and highlight the perfect look. Accentuate your best features and bring out the very best in you with this exclusive collection. All right, so here is the packaging. Very cute, very sleek looking. Open it up here, and it looks like we have, I'm assuming, the translucent powder. We have bronzer, blush, and highlight. Highlight? Whoo, y'all, this highlight is freaking dark. Hold on. Is that even gonna work on my skin tone? Oh, honey, there is that. Is that supposed to... Did I buy the light one? Because the packaging does say that this is the Fair Light option, but that highlighter on Fair Light skin, I don't know, maybe it's just because I'm like super fair, but that does look very, I mean, I think on camera, because you're catching the reflection, it looks a lot lighter, but in real life, I mean, look at that. That looks really dark. You know what? Maybe it is just a me thing, because these other shades don't look too shabby. Like the blush is gorgeous. The bronzer, I think, will definitely work. Let's go ahead and get some swatches going here. Oh my gosh, these are all so gorgeous. That blush is everything. It's like a rosy pink color. Absolutely stunning. Bronzer is perfect. Also very, very velvety smooth. Color is on point. Okay, no issues. And then you know what? Last but not least, there's a little swatch of translucent powder right here, which is this lighter shade. And even that's super beautiful. You know what? I might end up using that to shape out the face, because it's actually quite a bit lighter than what I'm using in the actual powder. I'm actually, guys, I'm kind of digging this. The only thing that has me a little bit on edge is because I know that this is too dark, but the rest of them look gorgeous. So let's go ahead here and get into it. All right, so really quick here, I'm just going through, I'm removing all the powder under my eyes, as well as any like leftover powder just sitting on the face. I want to make sure everything is nice and smooth. So first up, I'm going to go in with bronzer right here, and this is an EcoTools bronzer brush. I'm just going to lightly get in here. I know the shape of the pan isn't necessarily ideal for my size of a brush, because I do prefer my bronzer blushes to be a little bit more on the fluffy side, but I'm just gonna take and get it as coated as I can, tap off the excess, and then let's start lightly kind of buffing it in. All right, so I'm having some pros and cons with this bronzer. Number one, I'll start off with some pros, okay? I do really, really love the tone of it. I think it looks gorgeous on my skin. I don't even go by the monitor anymore, because I can't tell ever what color I am. But if I look orange in the monitor, I am not in real life. It actually is probably one of the better tones that I've ever used. Like, it looks very natural on my skin, which is fantastic. So for me, color is really good. And I also really like the texture of it. I think that because it is such a fine mill, it just allows itself to be blended so effortlessly into my skin, which is perfect. My God, my bronzer is looking a damn mess in here, guys. I don't know what is going on. Why am I... Hold on, let me zoom the camera back out. All right, so I have no idea. I don't think that that really helped at all, like zooming out. For some reason, this side of my face is like so dark and so shadowed, which is interesting, because I actually have better light today than I've had in the last several weeks. So I don't know, but you know, just keep that in mind. If things are looking crazy, and especially right here, for some reason, is looking real kind of crazy. My forehead's looking weird. I don't know. Just ignore that and move on. Also, I'm having a hot flash from hell. So, you know, something to keep in mind. That has nothing to do with the color, but everything to do with me and the fact that I feel like I'm dying right now. All right, so now that my whole bronzer saga is over, let's go ahead and dive into this blush. I'm going to use a It Cosmetics. This is their Flawless Blush Brush, and I freaking love this color. I'm going to tell you right now, short of this going on my face and looking purple or something, I am really going to enjoy this, because, oh my God, the color is everything. I'm going to start back here and just lightly bring it down. Yep, love that. Love, love, love that. Okay, Paige, put the brush down. Quit going in. Oh my God, guys, I will keep sitting here and adding blush until we both die. All right, so next up, I'm actually gonna go in here and shape out the face and do brows, and then we'll circle back to the highlight. So I'm gonna go in just like I was going to with the other powder, or just like I normally do, I guess, and I'm going to Use the powder in the palette to lightly shape out, oh, that's actually pretty good, to lightly shape out the face here, starting under the eyes, and just to kind of balance out, give a little bit of brightness back to these spots. Also, just throw in a little bit here along the jawline, just for a touch of definition. It doesn't really have to be super sharp right there. I just want to add a little something. Now, really quick though, I am going to dive into my brows. I'm just going to go in here with my ABH Brow Wiz. This is in the shade medium brown. And then just real quick over top of that, I'm taking some of my Benefit Gimme Brow Gel in the shade 3.5, just for a little bit of that nice fluffy color. All right, so now where we're at, I am going to go into highlight next, but I want to spray the face down with a little bit of the It Cosmetics Your Skin But Better setting spray first. And then I'm just going to go in here into the highlight with my BH number 18 brush. It's more of a fluffy highlighter brush. And I'm just going to, you know, work it in like I normally would here. Check the color. Okay, so you know what, guys? Shockingly enough, it's not as dark as I thought it was going to be. Like, it's definitely still a skosh too dark to be a highlight on my skin tone, but it's actually really beautiful. So I'm actually going to take, and instead of going in with any more of that, I'm going to go in with a lighter highlight. Let's grab this one. This is the Dior Backstage Highlight. I've used this a lot as of late, and I'm going to go in here, mix a teeny bit of this golden shade, but mainly going into the white shade right here, just to really help me kind of tip off and blend into this highlight, just hopefully to take away that muddy effect that I'm getting back here. Oh my God, this highlight is gorgeous. And I'm also gonna take this one from Dior here and put this on the inner corner and the brow bone. And then just to help blend stuff a little bit more, I'm gonna grab some of my e.l.f. Halo Glow Setting Powder here. I'm actually gonna start that right up on the cheekbone and then lightly blend it down over the whole cheek just for more of a refining, kind of a finishing powder. And then finally, one last spritz here with my Catrice Dewy Glow Setting Spray. All right, now finally we're onto the last product from Pure. This is their 4-in-1 mascara with hemp, and this is called their On Point Mascara. And it says here that this is a high volume hemp infused mascara that adds drama to the look of lashes. It will separate, lengthen, and thicken the appearance of your lashes with intense black pigment that leaves a lasting impression. All right, so first of all, not upset at all with this wand. It does have more of a thick fullness to it. Like, it has a good amount of really like wiry bristles, and the formula feels like it's a little bit more on the like thick slash dry side. So that's interesting. Let's go ahead. Actually, I want to curl up my lashes. Almost forgot. This is just my Tarte Lash Curler here. And the texture of the actual mascara doesn't feel like super thin and runny. It's more of a thick slash dry kind of texture to it. So that'll be interesting. I'm just going to go ahead and build up a few coats here. Definitely has a thicker feel to it. That's for sure. I can tell just in the first couple of swipes onto the lashes, it feels, you know how like after you've used a mascara a few times, how it starts to really feel like thick inside the jar? That's how this feels. Not in like a bad, you know, like it's old kind of way or anything like that, but it just has that level of thickness to it while I'm working it onto the lashes. And all right, you guys, with that, I did go ahead and just throw in a lip. Obviously the full face is done, but I wanted to mention, just so you guys know what lip I went in with, I actually did a cute little combo. I've been playing with this one a lot lately. It's gorgeous. This is the ColourPop Lippy Pencil in the shade Beeper, which has more of like a pinky kind of mauve-y hue to it. And then in the center of that, I put the M Cosmetics Lip Cushion in Faded Clementine, which is more of obviously an orangey kind of tone. And the two together just pair really beautiful. Like, I love that combination. But from there, I do want to go ahead and get over into the mascara, finalize that, and then kind of give you guys my wrap-up thoughts and opinions. And while I was up close, I actually went ahead and did, you know, obviously all the up close shots, but also some of just the mascara. That way you guys could see kind of what it does to the lashes. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that up, and then we can kind of walk through everything. And starting off with the mascara, I actually have to say I'm pretty impressed with this, because normally for me with my lashes, a drier formula mascara doesn't really work all that well. It usually gets like very clumpy and very almost like drug through on my lashes, where it looks clumpy, like literally clumpy from roots to tips, which is not my vibe. And I like that with this one, even though it does have a little bit of clump to it, they still have a nice natural kind of voluminous to them, which I really appreciate. I will say at this point, it didn't build up a ton. Like, it didn't build as much as I would like, but it does look really pretty. I think for me, like, my complexion looks gorgeous. I don't have any issues with it. I think everything is very smooth. The bronzer, blush, highlight, like all of the products in that face palette blended gorgeous. And I love that on my skin, they are very, very weightless, very velvet looking. It is a soft matte finish, which is fantastic for me. And And I love the way that all of that, it's very smooth again. No issues there. And then also too, you know, not even just with that palette, but my under eyes, all the places where I put the concealer and that loose powder look absolutely gorgeous. So I definitely agree that there is something about the loose powder itself that has a nice light blur to it. So I'll definitely keep testing that out because my under eyes look fantastic. I think that the concealer so far is holding up really well. And especially, you know, when paired with something like the powder being so finely milled up under my eyes, I know I mentioned this, but normally I have issues with that, like settling in, getting really cakey and crevassy. And I'm noticing that with all of these products, I'm not seeing, you know, any of that really. Like there's no presence of caking, of creasing, nothing like that up under here. There's no issues like on my texture along my jawline, nothing like that either. So far so good there. And with the little lip product here, that Forever Soft Rejuvenating Lip Treatment, this I'm kind of on the fence about because I do feel like, and obviously I only wore it for a little time, you know, I've been filming for maybe an hour and a half, two-ish hours, so it's not a crazy amount or anything. But with this one, what I'm noticing more than anything is that it does soften the lips, like it gives them a really beautiful like feel, texture to them. But at this point, I can't really tell if that's just a surface moisturize or if it's the kind that's really gonna penetrate. So what I'll do with this one is I'll wear it to bed, you know, and I'll kind of wear it for a few more days to get a feel for it. Oh, and you know what? There is one more thing I wanted to mention with this palette specifically. I was getting done here, like, you know, just going through kind of looking in the mirror, finishing up my face, and I noticed that in my bronzer and my blush, there's kind of these weird little, and even in the translucent one right here, there's kind of this weird little like texture to it, like little balls in the powder. It's hard to describe. I'll go ahead. I tried to get it up close. Okay. I don't have like no little magnifying glass, so I don't know if it's going to show up, but I'm going to go ahead and throw up the footage that I took to see if maybe I can get you guys to see it. But there's like this weird little bumpy situation in the powder here, and I'm not sure what that's all about. I don't know if that's just, you know, like the mixture of the batch, if it's something that affects it, if it won't affect it, I'm not really sure. But just something I wanted to mention because I did see it. And again, I don't know if that's a problem. You guys can let me know down below. But I will say, to be fair though, I have seen, you know, texture like this pop up in other powders, like from Tarte and stuff like that. So I'm hoping that it's not anything like super out there crazy. I don't think it's going to cause any problems necessarily, but I am really curious to see, you know, if it should be there, if it shouldn't, you know, kind of what the deal is with that. So if you guys have any info or you know what it is, please feel free to let me know down below. But from there, you guys, I don't have anything else to say. So let me know your thoughts again, whether it is on the products, if you were curious, if you're not curious, whatever it is. And also too, do you like Pure, like just as a brand, or do you have a favorite product? Because I feel like they are one of those brands that people are so polarized on. Like I've heard it from both directions. You know, people don't like them because they've been in so many BoxyCharms, or they don't like the quality, whatever. But then a lot of other people really love, you know, like their foundation powder or their foundation, that 4-in-1 or 10-in-1, whatever the hell that one was that Raw Beauty Christie likes. Some people really love them for that or for their bronzers. And I feel like they're always so polarizing, like one way or the other. So what are your guys' thoughts? Again, whether it's the brand, the stuff we talked about, I just want to hear from you down below. And also, oh yeah, don't forget, like I said at the start of the video, make sure you subscribe, turn on your post notifications, follow me on Instagram. Everything would be greatly, greatly appreciated. And thank you all again so, so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Yeah. Bye. Like honestly, when I tell you I'm sweating, oh my dear God, okay? Profusely sweating. Like I could be working out right now doing full on Richard Simmons mojo, and I, oh my God, I'm sweating. It is so hot in here. Oh my God, the amount of sweat that is behind my knee. Oh my God. Also, I'm not wearing any pants. Fun fact for the bloopers. Bitch don't got no pants on. You know why? Did I mention I'm sweating? I had to take my pants off. I took my pants off. I rolled up my sleeves. And when I tell you, okay, if all of this wasn't on camera, I wouldn't be wearing a shirt either. Okay. That is how hot it is in here. Whew. And the amount of sweat. Oh my God. Oh, you hear that? Oh, that's me sticking to the chair. To the chair. Sticking to the chair. I'm sticking to the chair like a bug to the wall. I'm sticking to the chair. That's my new hot hit single coming out later this year. I'm like a bug sticking to my chair because I'm sweaty, sweaty, sweaty.